relatively close race there now between Trump, Clinton, and my next guest, the man chosen by the Never Trump movement, independent candidate Evan McMullen. He's a Utah native who's on the ballot in 11 states. Evan, thanks so much for joining me.
Great to be with you, Jake. We're on the ballot in 11 states, but we're registered as a write-in in a number of others. The total will be 40 to 45 states where we have ballot access on Election Day.
All right, good to know. If the election goes the way polls are showing right now, and Republicans suffer a defeat, what message should the party take from that? Is it about Donald Trump, or is it about something bigger?
Well, it is about Donald Trump, but it is also about something bigger. But these are lessons that the party should have learned after 2012. And in fact, these are lessons that the party did learn after 2012, that it needed to appeal to millennials and women and minorities much more than it did in that past presidential election. The challenge is that the party wasn't able to implement changes that it knew it needed to make. And after this election, with Donald Trump supporters so much more empowered than they ever have been before within the party, I find it hard to believe, and my running mate Mindy Finn agrees, that the Republican Party is likely to be able to make the reforms it needs to make to be viable in this country politically again, at least anytime soon. So we're building a new conservative movement that will welcome minorities, welcome women, people with disabilities, all kinds of people to our cause. And the question will be, is it necessary to start a new party, or is a movement enough?
Well, that's interesting that you say that the message was received but not implemented, because it seems to me like Republican leaders, I mean, I've never seen this kind of level of opposition to a party's own candidate. You know, Mitch McConnell is, you know, he's basically missing in action. Speaker Ryan, you know, sending out press releases as if there isn't a presidential race going on. There is not a lot of support. No living former Republican president supporting the nominee. And yet, I think there's a huge chasm, and I'm interested in hearing what you think, between party leaders and party members, Republican voters. Republican voters picked Donald Trump. It wasn't really even close.
Well, 47% of Republican voters selected Donald Trump in the primary, 53% selected someone else. But really, most Republican leaders in Congress have not disavowed their support for Donald Trump. And even those who have done so in a way that either stopped short of withdrawing their endorsement, or if they've withdrawn their endorsement, they haven't been able to say what they're for. They say what they're against, but not what they're for. And that's part of the problem. The problem is these leaders have failed to lead after 2012 and now. It's not enough to say what you're against. You actually have to say what you're for as a leader and then fight for that thing. And if they're not willing to do that, and if that thing is the basic truth that all men and women are created equal and then our inalienable rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, if they're not willing to stand for those principles, what business do they have leading the country? And I think that's the question that Americans are asking now as they witness the Republican support for Donald Trump.
Do you think you can win Utah? And if so, what effect might that have on the overall Election Day numbers?
Well, we're very encouraged by what we're seeing here in the polls. We're either neck and neck or we're leading. So we're very encouraged. Can we win? I believe we can prevail. There's still, of course, 2.5 weeks to go, so we've got to work hard. We see this enthusiasm spilling over into Idaho and Wyoming and elsewhere in the Mountain West. But what message it will send, I think, is simply that there has to be another way forward, and that is, I believe, a new conservative movement that will bring in more people into the fold, not by changing what we stand for, but rather simply recommitting ourselves to the fundamental, timeless truths that have made this country the most powerful and prosperous on earth. So we're going to try to use this movement to influence the Republican Party to do the right thing. But